morning to everyone. Kumusta po kayo? And I'm glad to be with you here. And last Thursday, nag-celebrate kami ng 38th wedding anniversary. Okay. Talagang you should congratulate my wife. She has a lot of patience. No, we enjoyed our life together and the goodness of the Lord. And this Thursday evening, we are having a simple celebration here at KBCF this Thursday evening. So join us and pray for us also for the ministry. Well, if you look at our bulletin, ang atin pong theme for the month of October, which is our missions month, is rooted in missions. We want that every believer, every KBCFer will really take deep root when it comes to mission. So the first Sunday we discuss about mission mandate, and that is taken from Romans chapter 10, how, you know, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. And how shall they believe unless they have heard? And how shall they hear until someone preaches? And how shall they preach unless someone sends them out? So it's important for us to say there's the mandate, because everyone needs to hear the gospel. Last Sunday, nagkaroon po tayo ng message on motivation for mission, taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 14, wherein the Apostle Paul said, "For the love of Christ compels us," at yung pong pag-ibig ng Panginoon is the one that motivates us to do mission. The next Sunday, October 28, ang ating focus is mission model. Ang model po natin ng ating Panginoong Jesucristo, "As the Father has sent me, so send I you." And so Jesus is sending us, and He is our model. And so today, we focus on the method of mission. And that is taken from Matthew 28, 16 to 20. Dun nga sa prayer ni ang ating kapatid na Brian, many of us have heard this passage of the scripture. Some of us have even memorized the scripture. Pero kuminsan, kahit na alam na natin, pinag-aralan na natin, memorize natin, hindi pa rin natin ini-implement at hindi pa rin natin sinasagawa. And so this morning, I think you have heard me say several messages on this passage already, but I want to again emphasize, as has been assigned, about the method for mission. We see here that Jesus gave His great commission that showed the method of doing mission. Ito yung namamaalam si Jesus sa kanya mga alagad, and He showed the method at nagbigay siya ng method of doing mission. So, reading from this passage, what is the method na ibinigay ni Jesus in this passage of the scripture? Ano hong pamamaraan in doing mission ang ipinakita ni Jesus dito? Wala ba? What is the method that Jesus showed here? Make disciples. We are to make disciples of all nations. That's the last word that Jesus gave to His disciples, that if we want to reach out the whole world doing this mission, we have to make disciples. So the question is, how can we make disciples? I have three guidelines or three principles na makukuha po natin in this passage of the scripture on how we can make disciples. First of which, we need to realize, what is the rationale for making disciples? What is the basis? What is the reason for making disciples? Notice that in verse 16, the 11 disciples came to Galilee. 11 na lamang, because Judas actually betrayed Jesus. At ngayon, you know, Judas is already gone. He already committed suicide. So the 11 disciples were there. Jesus resurrected. And sa tinawag niya ang kanyang mga disciples, go to Galilee, to the mountain that I will direct you. Anong nangyari? Verse 17. When they gathered there, the 11 disciples, they worshiped Him, but some doubted. Can you imagine that?
11 disciples, I don't know how many of them bowed down to worship him, but we also don't know how many doubted. I thought it was only Thomas who was doubting. Pero may kasama pa, because plural, some. There are several of them. We don't know how. How many, rather. But the point is, at that point when some of his disciples were doubting about Christ, siya ba talaga yung nag-resurrect na? Siya ba talaga yung merong authority? And one time, you know, he asked them, will you now restore the, will you now give the kingdom to the nation of Israel? At that point, ang sagot ni Jesus, when people are doubting, we know verse 18. And Jesus came and said to them, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Yung pagkasabi ni Jesus dun sa declaration, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me, immediately follows yung mga disciples na nagdududa, nag-aalinlangan. And it is to them that Jesus had to make a clear declaration. That is, on me, upon me, is all the authority in heaven and on earth. And so we say that the primary basis, primary reason for making disciple is what? Obedience to the supreme authority of the Lord Jesus. Lahat ng kapangyarihan sa langit at sa lupa ay nasa kanya. And therefore, that's the primary reason, primary basis why we are to make disciples. Because we obey the supreme authority of the Lord Jesus. Tingnan niyo ang katabi niyo, mukha bang pasaway? Okay? Marami po sa atin hanggang ngayon pasaway pa rin. And I like to ask the question, why are we not making disciples? Well, some of us might say, well, I don't know how. Well, kung you don't know how, then somebody could help you. Or maybe, ang mas mahirap yung, I don't have the time. I'm too busy. I'm too engaged. I'm too involved with so many other things. I work so much, and wala na akong panahon. Well, I have a problem here. Because if that's the reason why we are not making disciples, I would say that the real problem there is, we obey men rather than God. We obey man rather than Jesus. Bakit po, and I think I have already said this here, that as we work Monday to Friday, we wake up early morning, pipila tayo dyan para sumakay sa MRT, o kaya sa bus, and lahat. Ilang oras ang biyahe natin, ayaw nating mahuli sa trabaho. You give your 8 hours a day, and then come back, makikipagbuno ka na naman sa siksikan sa sasakyan. Why is it that 5 days a week, eh kayang-kaya mong gumising na maaga, magtrabaho maghapon, at talagang magpakapagod in order to say, I don't want to be late, or I want to do my best, I want to have promotion, I have to have work. Sabi niya, because they are the ones who provide our paycheck. They are the ones who provide our salary. Well, tama. Binibigyan niya tayo ng kanilang salary. Binibigyan tayo ng ating pinagkakakitaan. Pero si Jesus, anong ibinigay niya sa atin? First of all, he is the one who created us. Colossians 1 tells us, in Him, everything was created. Kung siya po ang lumalang sa atin, ano naman ang ibabalik natin sa kanya? And siya po ang nagbigay ng kanyang buhay para sa atin. He was the one who gave himself to redeem us. Siya ang lumalang sa atin, siya ang tumubos sa atin in return. Kumahog ba tayong makipila at sasabihin, oh, I want to serve Jesus. I want to do discipleship. I want to do this. Because Jesus gave His life for me. Hindi ko ata naririnig yun. Pero sa trabaho, kayang-kaya nating ibigay yung ating more than 40 hours a week. But doing discipleship, sabi ko nga, ang problema natin, we obey men more than Jesus. But the root cause really of this is the problem that we love ourselves more than Jesus.
kaya ka nagpapakabagod, kaya ka nagtatrabaho, kasi kailangan mo ang para sa pagkain, para sa pamumuhay, para sa pang make up, lahat, para gumanda ka. May pag-asa pa rin tayo, di ba? Because our attention, our desire is more for ourselves. Kaya nga sabi ni Jesus, one of his demands for his discipleship, if you want to be my disciple, you need to deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me. And so it's important for us to say that when it comes to making disciples, we do that because we want to obey Jesus. We want to really honor Him and recognize Him. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to Him. Therefore, it is incumbent upon us na tayo po ay gumawa ng mga alagad. Do we say amen to that? Second, na ipinakita ni Jesus, in order for us to make disciples, we need to recognize the reins of making disciples. Notice na sinabi niya, we are to make disciples of all nations. Ibig sabihin, the task that we have to accomplish, the task that we have to do, is not only bound here in KBCF, or Kamuning, or Quezon City, or the Metro Manila, Philippines, but all nations. Now, the word all nations here is not referring to geopolitical nation, but the word there is ethnic group. Panta ethne. All ethnic groups or people groups. So the globe, so the range of the Great Commission, the range of making disciples is global in scope. We have to reach all people's group. Nandiyan ba kayo? Okay. All people group ay dapat po nating maabot. In fact, in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, nakita po natin dito yung sinabi ni Jesus na you will become my witnesses where? In Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the end of the earth. So kung sa ating sasabihin nga, our Jerusalem is our local community, kung taga-Kamuning tayo, that's our Jerusalem. But beyond our Jerusalem, we have to go to the rest of Metro Manila, and then from Metro Manila, we want to go up north to the to Central Luzon, south to Bicol and Visayas and Mindanao, and to the end of the earth. So ang atin pong ministry is global. Local as well as global. Kaya ang paggagamit ni Dr. Luke dyan, you will be my witnesses both in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and to the uttermost parts of the earth. That's why in Revelation chapter 7 verse 9, we see there that the Apostle John had that vision that the mission of God is actually accomplished. Why is it accomplished? A great multitude, sabi niya, that no one could number from every nation and all tribes and peoples and languages. These are people who are standing beside the throne and before the Lamb. They are saying, salvation belongs to God. So makikita po natin na in the future, as revealed to Apostle John, the mission is accomplished. That people na hindi mabilang from every nation, tribe, people, and language. So, in terms of the fulfillment of the Great Commission, it will be done. God will make it happen. The desire of Jesus is that everyone will have an opportunity to come to Him. He does not, you know, kahit nga yung promise niya to come back, He is not slow. Why? Because He does not want that anyone should perish, but that everyone will have an opportunity to come to that to hear the word of God and to have that repentance. So it will be accomplished. The Great Commission will be done. The question is, how will these multitudes be reached? The answer goes back to Matthew 28, that we have to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. Now the question is, how many commands are given by Jesus? I hope this is already clear to us because we have gone through this passage several times. How many commands? Yung iba nagdududa pa. Sisito, alam na. Only one, okay? How many commands?
One.
Only one, okay? What are those? Only one. The green part, make disciples. This is just the verb. The others are what we call participles. The way it is translated in English is go as if it is a command. But it should be translated as you are going. So it is a participle. A participle is the part of the speech or sa grammar that helps the main verb. So the main verb is only one, make disciples. But as you are going, baptizing and teaching. So, making disciples involves a comprehensive process. So, the one word is to make disciples. How do we make disciples? In order for us to make disciples, the three words, going, baptizing, and teaching. So, yung tubong going, baptizing, and teaching. So, as you are going, whether you are in school, whether you are in the office, whether you are in the community, in the marketplace, or kahit saan, nakasakay sa bus, may nakakausap, as you are going in your normal walk of life, wherever you go, then you have to share, you have to testify, you have to witness about who Jesus Christ is. Tell people about what who Jesus Christ is, what He has done. Kaya nga meron tayong, you know, either sa ating training sa EE, have you come to the point in your life where you know for sure that if you die, you're going to heaven? O meron tayong gift of God card, anong gusto mo? Death or life? Death or life? Diba? Because we want the people to come to know Jesus and then he becomes a new believer. Now, when a person becomes a new believer, you do not stop helping that person. You continue helping that person and that is the second stage, baptizing them or to establish them in the faith so that they will become a committed follower of Jesus. By the way, the word to baptize is to show that they are now making that public identification and commitment to follow the Lord Jesus. Kaya nga, tayo dito po sa KBC, meron tayong baptism. So that as you are baptized, ipinapakita mo na yes, in your life, you put your trust in Jesus one time, and now you are making a public declaration, hindi mo ikinahihiya si Jesus, at habang ikay inilulubog, literally, para bang nangyari ito na you were buried in your sins, and nung ikaw ihanguin, at yung iba sa atin, kailangan sigurong patagalin ng konti sa tubig, no? Nung ikaw ihanguin, then it means you are raised to new life. You are now a new creation because of Christ. It did not happen during baptism. It happened when you received Christ. But now you are making a public declaration of what happened when you put your trust in Christ. So you are making that commitment so that you are a committed follower of Jesus. But then as you are a committed follower of Jesus, you want to be equipped teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you so that you will become a multiplying discipler. Now you begin to help other people. You begin to grow, nurture other believers so that they will also grow spiritually. So the whole process of disciple making, from evangelizing to establishing them in the faith to equipping them or going, baptizing and teaching. New believer, committed follower of Jesus to a multiplying disciple maker. Apostle John made his own stages of development in 1 John chapter 2 verse 14, 12 to 14. If you have your Bibles, you open. If not, you can just follow in this passage. 1 John chapter 2 verse 12 to 14. Apostle John was addressing three groups of people. He said in verse 12, I am writing to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven for his name's sake. So he is addressing the little children. And then verse 13, he identified the three. I'm writing to you fathers, because you know him who is from the beginning. And then I'm writing to you young men, because you have overcome the evil one. And then he said, I write to you children, because you know the father. So there are three stages and three classifications. Father, young men, children. Verse 14, he repeated, the fathers, I write to you, you know him who is from the beginning. I write to you, young men, because you are strong. And then he gave the explanation why they are strong. Because the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the evil one. So what I want us to see here is just see the matrix of the stages, characteristics, the focus, as well as the intervention. In the process of disciple making, what are the three stages? First, they are children. They become a child as a result of the evangelism. So their characteristics, their sins are forgiven, they know the Father. Therefore, our focus there is help this new believer to have assurances. That's why we begin by assurance of salvation, assurance of forgiveness, assurance of answered prayer, assurance of guidance. So we want the person to be assured that his sins are forgiven at meron siyang personal relationship with the Father. But then, second stage is young men. Anong characteristics ng young men? They are strong. They are able to overcome the evil one, and the word of God abides in them. Kaya in this process of helping them, ito yung tinatawag nating intervention, establishing them in the faith, we want them to have a deep commitment to Jesus. Okay? And then the third stage is the fathers. The characteristic, they know him who from the beginning, meaning they have that extensive knowledge, fellowship, relationship with the Father. And ang ating focus dyan is multiplying in ministry. So our intervention, equipping and teaching them. So makita natin the outline that was given in Matthew 28, going, baptizing and teaching, or evangelizing, establishing them in the faith, as well as equipping. Sinabi rin ni Apostle John, children, young men, and fathers. Now, how many of us are still little children? Okay? After 20 years of our spiritual life, our walk with God, we need to grow from being little children to becoming young men or young women who are strong, who are committed, who are really growing as a committed follower of Christ. But after that, we continue to go on until we become spiritual parents. So we become the father and mother of the faith for some people, helping them to be nurtured in the spiritual life. Kaya kung tayo po hanggang ngayon ay little children, medyo tampuhin o medyo madaling sumama ang loob, medyo kapatid, kinakailangan itulak ng kaunti para ikaw ay maging young man o young woman who is strong, who is really deeply committed with the Word of God. Kaya tinutulungan natin silang mag-Bible study, mag-memorize ng scripture, mag-quiet time, so that the Word of God abides in them and they become strong. Pero pagkatapos nun, then they begin to help other people upang sila naman ang maging spiritual mother or father. So nakita natin yung matrix. Okay? So again, ang question ko, where are you in these stages? I hope we do not remain little children. Yes, we need to have childlike faith, but we should not remain children. We should grow up. And we should come to that point that we will have that opportunity to multiply in ministry. Okay? The third, na pinakita po ni Apostol ng ating Panginoon, how we can make disciples, is we need to rest on the resource for making disciples. And what is that greatest resource? Pangako ni Jesus. And behold, I am with you always till the close of the age. The promise of Jesus, I will be with you. There will be times, tayo pinagpala sa Pilipinas dahil wala tayong persecution. Wala tayong pressure. Diba? Medyo kwan po tayo, mga laki sa layaw tayo. Wala tayo, our faith, hindi na challenge. Maaring siguro sa eskwela pinagtatawanan tayo, kine-question tayo, but that's nothing compared to other place in other places where their lives are on the line. The closest that I had was several years ago when nung nandun pa rin po ako sa PCEC. One time I received an email from Abdul Rahman 911. At dun sa email na yon, sinabi niya, "Why are you sending missionaries here in Mindanao? You are the leader of the church in the Philippines, and we ask you to ask the missionaries to leave Mindanao." Sabi ko, hindi naman ako nagpadala sa kanila. Ang Panginoon nagpadala sa kanila. Hindi ko agad siya sinagot. Although sabi ko, sino kaya itong Abdul Rahman na ito? 911. Pangalawang email niya, "Huwag kang matigas ang ulo. We are just watching you in the neighborhood." Parang gano'n na. "At I'm just waiting for the signal from our elders. And we will, your head may be hard, but your neck is soft." May mga ganong threat na, di ba? Pangatlo, sumagot na ako sa kanya, "It's not me who sends them, it's Jesus who sends them." Pero tapos sumagot uli siya. So may isang nagsabi sa akin, "Baka kailangan mo na magkaroon ng bodyguard, security." Sabi ko, "Hindi, nandiyan na ang misis ko eh." There was a time na we had a conference. Pumunta po ako sa Butuan. At this is the height ng pagdating doon, may sumundo sa akin sa airport at talagang binantayan ako. Tapos pagpasok doon sa hotel room, pumasok muna siya. Sinilip niya, sabi ko, "Ano ba? Para itong nanonood ako ng sine." Sabi ko, "Ano?" Tapos, maya-maya sabi niya, "Ako naman ho, nakahanda na ako." Tapos nilagay niya yung kanyang 45 doon sa mesa. Sabi ko sa kanya, "Kapatid," sabi niya, "ang mission order ko is to give my body to the bullet that will be given to you." No, sabi ko, ang bait naman itong mamang ito. Sabi ko, "Kapatid," sabi ko sa kanya, "umuwi ka na. Kasi kailangan ka ng pamilya mo. At kung ibibigay mong buhay mo para sa akin, wag naman para sa akin. Para sa..." Sabi ko, "I will not be foolish. I'll not go out of this compound. Pero secure na ako dito. Umuwi ka na." So pinauwi ko na po siya. I have not, hanggang ngayon, wala pa rin akong bodyguard. Why? Because I have the greatest bodyguard of all. Amen? Who can be greater than the Lord Jesus? When Jesus says, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me." At ang kanyang pangako, "I will be with you always till the close of the age." Mga kapatid, the promise of the Lord Jesus is that His power and His presence will be with us. Amen? Pero basahin pa rin ho natin sa context. The promise of His power and presence are to those who are making disciples. Kaya kung hindi ka naggagawa ng disciple, if you're not involved in disciple making, wala kang karapatang sabihin, "Jesus, protect me. Jesus, I want your presence." Because the context of this is that as you are making disciples, as you are going, as you are baptizing, as you are teaching, I'm promised to Jesus, "And lo, I am with you always till the close of the age." So you want to be secure in life? You want to be protected all the time? Be involved in disciple making. Get involved in training others. Get involved in nurturing others. Get involved in helping others to grow spiritually. Because the promise of Jesus, as you are going, as you are baptizing, as you are teaching, "I am with you always till the close of the age." Now, which method will reach the world for the Lord Jesus? Na I-share ko na rin po ito, but I think it's important for us to rehearse it again. Well, you can have a faithful discipler who leads one disciple a year. Or you have a gifted evangelist who leads 1,000 converts to Christ a day. Alin ang mas mabilis? Naalala niyo ba? Yes. How long will it take to reach 8 billion? Well, faithful discipler, year 2 maging, so year 1 isa sila, naging dalawa, tapos year 2 maging 4, year 3 maging 8, year 4 maging 16, year 5 maging 32, ilang taon bago maabot yung 8 billion. Yung gifted evangelist who leads 1,000 converts to Christ a day, wow, how long will it be to reach 1,000 converts a day? For the faithful discipler, it will only take how many years? 32 years. For the gifted evangelist, 21,900. Sino kaya mabubuhay ng 21,917 years? Halos 22,000 years? Imposible, di ba? But what I'm trying to say here is, as we make disciples, it's still possible for us to reach the whole world for the Lord Jesus, even in our lifetime. Meron bang mabubuhay pa dito ng 30, another 30 years or 32 years? Ako ata medyo mahirap-hirap na yun. 61, 32, 90 plus, 94. Ba si Henry Linga, kumandidato pa uli, no? Sabi ko, si Mahathir, okay lang. Pero, ang point here is, while we are still alive, it's still possible. Right? Pakisabi sa katabi mo, kapatid, posible. Yes. For that to happen, we need to seek spiritual multiplication. Yung last two trips namin ng mag-asawa ni Sherry, nakakatuwa na, you know, Sherry, we were in Vancouver, and then we're there talking with Mila Amante, and then all the Amante, Kayari family, and then tinetrace namin, how did you come to KBCF? And how did you grow spiritually? Sabi niya, because one person invited me, and they discipled me, and they helped me to grow. And so makita yung, because people invested their lives and helped them to grow spiritually, then they now God is using them in their places of ministry. We went to San Francisco. Namit namin si Josie. Anong apelido ni Josie? Sabi ni Sherry, oh, paano ka nakapunta sa KBCF? Dahil si Tess Tagunicar was the one who invited me and discipled me. And then Tess was also discipled by Sherry. Kaya sabi niya, oh, ikaw pala, apo ko ito, si Josie. Oh, pumunta kami sa, you know, different cities where we go. Nandun ang mga KBCFers. And then we ask, why are you here? And when did you come to KBCF? Because somebody invited me, somebody discipled me, somebody nurtured me spiritually. Now I'm continuing to grow spiritually. Punta kami sa London. Si Gemma, ano ito? Garcia. Oh, tapos may iba pang mga KBCFers. So ibig sabihin, kahit saan magpunta, doon lang ata sa Bolivia wala dahil mga Espanyol na mga tao nandun. Pero mga KBCFers, nakakalat. Yung iba medyo nagkakalat siguro, no? Hindi naman. Nakakalat. Pero kahit saan sila nandun, ginagamit sila ng Panginoon. Why? Because someone invested their lives by helping them to come to know the Lord, nurturing them, guiding them, helping them to grow spiritually. So, what is the last command of Jesus? Ito na, namaalam siya. Gather the 11 disciples. Sabi niya, aalis na ako. I will be taken out. I'm going home to glory. My last command, make disciples. His last command is our first concern. Yung last will and testament, napakahalaga yan. Iginagalang yan, sinusunod yan. This is the last will and testament of Jesus. And the last will and testament is our first concern, to make disciples. So nandun po yung ating discussion questions that you can do in your cell group. What keeps you from doing the main thing that Jesus wants you to do?
That's the main thing that Jesus wants us to do, to make disciples. Bakit po tayo walang oras, walang panahon, walang the interest?
Are we disobedient children? Are we focused more on ourselves rather than Jesus? If anyone wants to be my disciple, you must deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me, Jesus said. Are we willing to do that? How can you be involved in the discipleship process at KBCF? Are we still little children? Are we growing to become young men or young women? Are we going to that point where we are becoming mothers and fathers, helping others to bring spiritual multiplication? This is the most important command of Jesus. Are we following His command? Manalangin po tayo. Panginoon, lumalapit po kami sa inyo. We ask that you would forgive us for the way we have neglected your main command, your last command. For the way we have given more importance to ourselves, as made manifest now, we can follow our employers, other people, but neglect your command. And so help us to be obedient children. Help us not to stagnate to become little children, but grow to become young men. Grow to become fathers and mothers. Help us to be involved in spiritual multiplication. Salamat po sa iyong patuloy na gabay, tulong at panguna, so that we can really see spiritual multiplication happening. Lord God, sa KBCF, we see many other people who needs to be reached with the gospel. Our neighbors, our friends, people who are close to us. And then even as we look beyond, millions of people who are in need. Help us in one way or another, even to contribute to that point that we can bring spiritual multiplication. Thank you for how you will help us to be obedient children who will be making disciples for the Lord Jesus. This is our prayer and what we ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. God bless you.